and I never imagined that I would make a living off of belly dance, so I started in 1978. I did it off and on, and then I started taking it seriously, really seriously, a couple of years ago, and I started really working hard at it. My mother was a belly dancer. At least she started off, and she's a pretty good dancer. She can do the shimmy. Well, my family's from Puerto Rico, and they just happen to be good dancers. You know, they can pick up really easily. So. People think that this is exotic dancing. I mean, they think of it as stripping, but this dance is so ancient, so old. It was done more or less, well, there's a lot of ways that it's originated. Partly was imitating nature, like a little duck that walks a certain way, and you get the same little wiggle when you dance. Or it could be, a lot of this was done to appease the spirits. In Egypt, they have what they call the Zaar, a lot of those North African countries. And it's a type of dance that's done to either exorcise a bad spirit or to appease a good spirit. So its origins are not, you know, sexual or anything like that. Maybe it was a little enticing, but it came from a different source, I believe. Fire eating is sort of a trade secret. It's not normal for belly dance. Most belly dancers don't eat fire, but it's very dangerous. I don't suggest that anybody try it, you know, unless you've been trained. And it's scary when you first start doing it. And then it's nothing like that. I used to burn my tummy a lot, you know, because I don't know why this area was so sensitive. And let's see, one time that the torch came off and came off in my mouth, and I spit it into an ashtray. Perfect. That's pretty important if you're going to work all the time and you don't have anything else but television or the same old, this is a creative outlet. The other thing is that it's a fantastic exercise. I know women that had very hard labors, and in the very fact that they were belly dancers, they knew how to push a certain way, they were able to have it a lot easier. They wouldn't have been able to have it naturally otherwise. Let me see. Exercise. Just plain old exercise. It's sort of aerobic. And it's also, you get to, it's like massaging yourself on the inside. And you get to know muscles that you never knew you could use. You know, diaphragms, you know, for undulating. And a lot of things that you never thought you could do.